Welcome to This Is My Architecture. I'm Yongjin Cho from AWS. Today, I have Gwansu Lee from beNX joining us. Hi, Gwansu. Thank you for joining.
Thank you for having me.
So can you tell me about beNX and your architecture?
Of course. beNX is an entertainment-based IT company behind many global artists, including BTS. We are running two services, Weverse and Weverse Shop. Weverse is an official fan community where global fans and artists interact, and Weverse Shop is a global merchandise shopping platform developed for our fans. As you know, BTS has a huge fandom. Because of that, we have a special traffic pattern. When a member of BTS posted a message, we've experienced up to 9 million TPM instantly. It's like hundreds times higher than usual. So we needed to come up with a solution to handle such a traffic.
Okay, well, I think it's very interesting that a single message post can bring up to 9 million TPM. I think it's really, really huge, and then you should have come up with very flexible and dynamic architecture.
Yes.
Can you tell me about how you architected your platform?
We call this event-driven auto-scaling architecture, which enables us to handle sudden and massive spikes in traffic. Of course, we may provision instances based on the peak traffic, but it could cost a lot, and actually it is not a proper way to utilize cloud. So we adopt this event-driven auto-scaling architecture.
Okay, so your architecture is event-driven auto-scaling architecture, right? And I think that's why you have this lambda in the diagram, right?
Yes.
So can you tell me more about your architecture?
Of course. Actually, we have two event cases, but today I want to focus more on unexpected events. When an artist creates a new post, notifications are sent to millions of users through push server. At the same time, it calls API gateway endpoint, which triggers a Lambda function. And this Lambda, in response to the massive traffic, makes a change to the auto-scaling group to meet the number of instances required.
Okay, so you're provisioning resources in the auto-scaling group using Lambda function, right?
Yes.
Okay. And I think this is about scaling out, but sometimes you have to go back to the original status, right? So how do you do that?
When the artist activity is done, then traffic returns to normal. And this is the time when we have to scale in instances. So we trigger another Lambda with AWS CloudWatch rule. And it checks API number of API and compare it to the normal state. And if the traffic is nearly normal, then the auto-scaling group returns to its own capacity.
Okay, this is great. So you're using CloudWatch to monitor the traffic patterns, right?
Yes.
And I just saw something very interesting here. So you're using spot instances in an auto-scaling group.
Okay.
And how do you use the spot instances?
Despite all this effort, intermittent delays exist. It causes latency issues because the time of incoming traffic received is way more faster than the healthy new instances created. This is inevitable because EC2 itself needs to boot up and have the application started and warmed up.
Right.
So our team notices that we have to provision instances in advance to handle all such event cases without any latency issue. So we changed our architecture to utilize spot instances. And currently, 70% of our instances are provisioned as spot. And thankfully, we saved the cost up to 50% in EC2.
Okay, so it's also a very clever thing that you can use spot instances in the auto-scaling group, right? So did you get any improvement in terms of latency with the spot instances?
Yes, since we adopt spot instances, we've no longer experienced any delay by cold start.
Okay, so you completely solved the problem of using the spot instances, right?
Yes.
And I have another thing, you know, that catches my eyes here. This GoPlayer, so I don't think this is an AWS service. Can you tell me about GoPlayer?
Yes, GoPlayer is a open source deployment tool that uses AWS auto-scaling. Our team made it to automate deployment process. It runs based on the configurations in the manifest file so that we can implement deployment as code. Actually, GoPlayer supports most of auto-scaling group features. So anyone who is using auto-scaling group can use our open source.
Okay, so basically this GoPlayer dynamically provisions auto-scaling groups, right?
Yes.
Oh, this is great. I think this can be a superstar in the CI/CD world.
Yes.
So thank you very much for the current architecture. And I just want to ask you, you know, what's your future direction of this architecture?
Absolutely. We're still in search for the best way to deal with sudden and massive spike challenge. So we are considering EKS Fargate for EKS.
Okay.
EKS alone requires more node if I want to run more pod. But with the Fargate, we don't need to provision more node for additional pod. So we expect that this could help us operate our services more reliable and cost efficient.
Okay, so thank you very much for the explanation. And I think you have a plan to make your life easier with AWS managed services, right?
Yes.
Okay. So today we introduced highly flexible architecture by beNX to handle massive peak traffic. Thank you for joining us, Guangzhou.
Thank you.
Thank you.